Hello, I'm Dr. Anthony Deese. I'm the chair of electrical and computer engineering here at the College of New Jersey. Thank you all for joining us. I'm going to spend just a couple minutes today talking about our program, about our department, the quality of our education, our research, our service to the community, as well as our state-of-the-art facilities. I think this will be very interesting to those of you that are potential students.
First, let's take a step into the brand new STEM academic building. This is a great space for our EC students to study, perform research, socialize, and work on group projects such as the solar-powered boat. As we move into the prototyping and machine shop, we see that our students have the ability to develop not only advanced electrical systems, but advanced electromechanical systems.
Now, bringing it back to Armstrong Hall, right now I'm in one of the main EC teaching laboratories. You can see there's space behind me where students sit in traditional lectures. There's also advanced workstations that students use in laboratory classes. But this space is used for more than just class. It's also available to students in their free time. They use this equipment to work on projects associated with their courses, with their senior capstone project, with research.
But it's also available to students that are simply interested in learning more about a given topic or technology. The School of Engineering has multiple rapid prototyping laboratories, sometimes referred to as makerspaces. They provide our ECE students with full access to advanced 3D printers like the Stratasys Dimension 1200ES and Formlabs Form 2. Students use these to create custom parts and packaging for various projects.
We continue our tour of Armstrong Hall. Next, we're going to take a look at one of the main research spaces, which focuses on three different areas: artificial neural networks and machine learning, advanced controls, as well as robotics.
This is only one of many ECE research laboratories we have here on campus. It stores hardware related to multiple projects, including the now NAO robots, the Rethink Robotics Baxter hardware. And students use this hardware to work on a variety of problems. One example is the use of self-learning fuzzy PetriNet algorithms to allow these now robots to actually play soccer. Another project is shown here, where students are exploring ways to stabilize complex nonlinear systems with advanced predictive control algorithms. And they're applying this theory to the hydraulic system shown.
Unfortunately, we aren't going to have time to tour all the electrical and computer engineering related research facilities here at TCNJ. We have many other labs focused on problems related to semiconductor device manufacturing and testing, wireless and RF technologies, antenna design, as well as advanced image processing. Behind me is my laboratory, the National Science Foundation funded Smart Electric Power System Laboratory. This electromechanical system built by LabVolt allows students to physically emulate phenomena such as electric grid blackouts, including the effect of renewable energy sources such as solar and wind.
I did want to spend 1 second talking about our electronics workstations, which allow students to tackle a variety of engineering problems. Much of the functionality is housed in this one unit, the National Instruments Virtual Bench, which when coupled with the graphical UI, allows students to use a digital multimeter, waveform generator, DC voltage source, as well as oscilloscope, all in one package. For more advanced projects, especially those associated with wireless technology, we also provide students with higher resolution, higher frequency digital oscilloscopes, spectrum analyzers, and waveform generators.
My name is Dr. Sun Kim. I'm an associate professor in electrical and computer engineering department at TCNJ. My research interests focus on mobile and ubiquitous computing and system and intelligent robotics with PetriNet modeling and simulation tools. We have a Baxter robot and many now humanoid robots in our robotics research lab. We published many refereed journals and proceedings, including most recent book chapter with TCNJ students in CRC Press.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Ambrose Adigbege. My research interest is in control systems engineering. My work has been published in the proceedings of the IEEE Conference on Decision and Control, as well as the International Federation on Automatic Control World Congress. My most recent work has just been submitted to the American Control Conference that will take place in New Orleans next year.
Hi, I'm Larry Perlstein. I'm a professor in the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering, and my research areas are twofold. I'm interested in a field known as deep learning, which is also called artificial intelligence these days, and I'm interested in mobile health systems. My students and I have recently presented our work at conferences. We had a presentation on our TCOM device for helping people to quit smoking, and we also have presented our work on a parameterized synthetic image generator, which is an application of generative adversarial networks for training neural networks to do
computer vision. Hi everyone, my name is Maruk. I recently joined TCNJ. My research interests are in antennas and propagations for 5G communications, satellite communications, and biomedical industries. In 2020, my work has been published in IEEE Transactions on Antennas and Propagations, which is one of the leading journals in antennas and propagations. I'm also planning to submit a paper regarding ultra-wideband antenna design in IEEE UCAP, which will be held in March 2021.
Hello, I'm Al Katz. I'm a fellow of the IEEE and a past Distinguished Microwave Lecturer. My area of interest is primarily in communications, microwave, electromagnetics, but I also have interest in radio astronomy and even the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. I work off at my students with this particular antenna. My specialty is in the area of distortion correction, where I really do my main research in, and that involves correcting the distortion of microwave power amplifiers or similar devices to what I have here. Thank you.
My name is Dr. Orlando Hernandez, and my research interests have to do with complex systems, those that involve high-performance digital systems, as well as high-precision analog subsystems. I have worked with embedded systems with different students, and I'm also currently working on a paper to be published at the World Forum on the Internet of Things next year, and it has to do with a novel transceiver for RFID applications.
Hello, my name is Dr. Udello Wandumagany. My research interest is on thin film transistors based on organic and inorganic semiconductors. This is a device that is applied in flexible electronics that includes flat panel displays, sensors, and RFIDs. My research is supported by the National Science Foundation, and I'm collaborating with research group at Johns Hopkins University. The most recent research results has been just accepted in the Journal of Computational Electronics for publication. I'm also working with students, and we are planning to submit results to the International FlexTech Conference next year.